Hi, I am Alexandros Stantos and I work as Assistant Professor of Text and Corpus Linguistics at the Department of Linguistics in Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. On behalf of the organizing committee, I take great pleasure in welcoming all the attendees of our second school on experimental and corpus linguistics, abbreviated as SECL, in Thessaloniki. Handling language data for linguistic research is not an easy task to accomplish. It requires skills that are intertwined with the domain of one's expertise, be that theoretical or applied linguistics. Becoming a proficient language data researcher takes time, and it would be unrealistic to claim that one can learn everything in a few days. However, all our courses intend to provide you with a necessary roadmap to handle the complexity of integrating good linguistic intuitions into experimental and corpus linguistic research. Now, my unit is related to responding to a series of questions, the answers to which will influence the direction, the depth, and quality of a linguist's research. For instance, knowing how to compile a corpus, how to conduct effective data wrangling, and finally, how to analyze quantitatively the data at hand, or in other words, how to quantify randomness and increase certainty in the formulation of theoretical results, are essential in building strong research skills. These issues will concern any linguist who enters research at one point or another.
In two of SECL's courses, mine and that of Vasilis Karagiannis, we will be using R, a scripting programming language with a rich inventory of packages that can handle all the tasks, statistical tests and analysis that we need for experimental and corpus linguistics datasets. As it usually happens with other programming languages, R2 comes with integrated development environments that make our job of using R much easier. For our purposes, we will be using RStudio throughout our sessions, a free open source environment. Before demonstrating RStudio's main features, let's take one step at a time and first install R and RStudio. So, first we need to visit R's official webpage, r-project.org. As you can see in the upper part of the page, there is a download link to follow. There is a number of mirrors that provide us with access to the software. You can choose a country that you live in or one nearby and follow the respective link. I will follow Greece's link. Next step is to choose the operating system of your machine. Assuming that most of you have Windows installed, you would have to choose the link for Windows PCs. After going through Base and download the file, you will install it pretty easily by clicking the Next and OK buttons until you get the message of a successful installation. Let's have a first look at where to find R's console, the place where you can directly interact with a language and type your commands. R, as any other software application, can be found in the Start menu between the rest of the applications. Next step is to download and install RStudio. You will have to follow the link on the screen and then under Products you choose RStudio. After that, you need to select the desktop version for your laptop or desktop computers. Among the available options, we would only need to choose the free version that includes most of the features we are interested in for our purposes. Finally, among the installers, you just need to find the one relevant for Windows. The downloaded file is a usual .exe file that you simply open and follow the screens by pressing the Next or OK buttons until the message about the successful installation pops up. I mentioned a couple of minutes ago that RStudio is a free, open-source integrated development environment for R. So, what does that mean? Well, basically, RStudio helps us focus on the process of writing code for our tasks without having to care about various repetitive tasks, such as switching to different working directories, installing and loading our packages, viewing the contents of loaded datasets and plotting graphs on the fly, among other things, and it does that by adding a lot more functionality, mainly through menus. Here is how the four panels of RStudio look like when you open it. The upper left panel is the editing part of RStudio, namely the place where you can write your own programs and then let R run the series of commands you have edited. The lower left panel holds R's console, where you may enter and execute your commands in a line-by-line fashion. I will not spend more time on the rest two panels, since they provide us with more details about R's working environment. Moreover, there are numerous excellent tutorials in YouTube and elsewhere to follow that will guide you through in detail as to how to use RStudio. We will also have the chance to touch upon its main features during the course, though. For the next days, I would recommend you to familiarize with R's basics. You don't need to develop full programming skills in R to follow this course, since we will focus on the features that address the questions mentioned in the beginning of this video. However, the familiarity with R's data types, such as vectors, data frames, and matrices, would benefit you in the process of becoming an informed user of language data analysis. There are a number of great free resources for learning the basics of the language or refreshing your memory, such as the interactive course provided by Swirl, a package installed and loaded within R, or DataCamp's free online introductory course on R.
There are only a few days left before our journey begins, and we, the organizing committee and the instructors, are all excited to see you all in Thessaloniki.